Hi everyone, welcome to our new topic of IPTV or setup box, that is H.264 video compression. So in this topic we will learn about what is H.264 video compression and where it is using nowadays and how it works, it means its working flows. For those who really wants to learn about the IPTV technology and HTV, please watch my previous session as well and be here from start to end so that you will learn to know about each and every concept of the H.264. And whenever you are trying to watching the general content of IPTV technologies and setup box, so please watch my previous session for the IPTV. So let's start with the H.264. So first of all, what is H.264? H.264 is an industry standard for video compression, the process of converting digital video into a format that takes up less capacity when it is stored or transmitted. Video compression or video coding is an essential technology for applications such as digital television, DVD video, mobile TV, video conferencing, and internet video streaming. Standardizing video compression makes it possible for products from different manufacturers, example encoders, decoders and storage media, to interoperate. An encoder converts video into compressed format and decoder converts compressed video back into an uncompressed format. So basically when we are working with the IPTV or DVB or in the setup box technology, so less contained is a very important part when transmitting data from one place to other place. So the broadcaster who is very they are using rich capacity or rich technology to compress data to produce. So basically storing bandwidth is a very important part in IPTV and STV technology. So for broadcaster who has stored much amount of bandwidth for transmission of data, so that will rich broadcaster in terms of transmitting data from one place to other place. So let's take example of the H.264 specification codec that was jointly developed by the International Telecommunications Union as H.264 and International Organization for Standardization and International Electrotechnical Commission Moving Picture Expert Group as a MPEG-4 Part 10 Advanced Video Coding or AVC. So basically that is also called as MPEG-4 Part 10 Advanced Video Coding or AVC. Thus the terms H.264 and AVC means the same thing and are interchangeable. As a video codec, H.264 can be incorporated into multiple container formats and is frequently produced in the MPEG-4 container format, which uses the .mp4 extension as well as quicktime.mov flash is equal to .f4b is a extension format of this 3GP for mobile phones, that is extension format is .3GP, and the MPEG transport stream that is also called as .ts. So basically these are the video transmitted with their extension name. So .ts, .f4b, .3GP, .mov is basically a extension name. So most of the time, but not all the time, H.264 video is encoded with the audio compressed with the AAC, Advanced Audio Coding codec, which an ISO IEC standard MPEG-4 Part 3. So I will create other video for the codec as well. So codec is basically a coding format for the encoding or decoding format for the audio and video. So I will make a video on the codec as well. So on the basic part, it's encoding and decoding formats for audio and video. So video coding and decoding process. The H.264 AVC standard was first published in 2003. It builds on the concepts of earlier standards such as MPEG-2 and MPEG-4 visual and offers the potential for better compression efficiency, that is better quality compressed video and greater flexibility in compressing, transmitting and storing video. At a high level, there is some uniformity in the compression parameters available for each codec. For example, H.264 codecs use different profiles to encode the video to explain where there are multiple encoding techniques and algorithms available in H.264 to compress the file. The basic trade-off for most of them is enhanced quality but a more complex bitstream that harder to decode. Profiles specify which of those techniques and algorithms can be used to create a bitstream and constitute a convenient meeting point for device manufacturers and video producers. For example, the baseline profile, which is the simplest profile predominantly used by low power devices, does not allow the use of B frame or KBAC entropy encoding. Quality is still good but not as high as streams. So basically, when we are producing using the main or high profile, that incorporates both the techniques. However, because those techniques weren't used, the coding requirements for a baseline encoded streams are modest, so low power devices like the original video capable iPod can only the video. The iPod documentation specified that these devices could only play H.264 video encoded to the baseline profile. So video producers seeking to produce content for playback on the iPod encoded using the baseline profile. H.264 level specify the maximum data rate and video resolution that a device can play back. For example, Apple's iPad 2 specification indicate that devices can play video encoded using the main profile level 3.1. This means the maximum video resolution of 1280x720 at 30 frames per second as a maximum data rate of 14 Mbps. So that is 14 MB per second. Next part is encoder process. So whenever we are talking about the encoder process, there are various encoding techniques which is used for the technologies. H.264 is industry standard for video compression. The process of converting digital video into format and takes up less capacity than it is stored or transmitted. Video compression or video coding is an essential technology for applications such as digital television, DVD video, mobile TV, video conferencing. So in the previous figure, prediction transform encode is basically a video encoder encoding decoding process and highlights the parts that are covered by the H.264 standard. H.264 or AVC standard was first published in 2003. It builds on the concept of earlier standards such as MPEG-2 and MPEG-4 visual and offers the potential for better compression. So next one is encoding process. The H.264 video encoder carries out the prediction transform and encoding processes to produce a compressed H.264 bitstream. An H.264 video decoder carries out the complementary process of decoding inverse transform of reconstruction to produce a decoded video sequence. So encoder process will contains prediction, intra-prediction and interpret. The prediction is basically two types, intra-prediction and inter-prediction. So let's have a look on the intra and inter-prediction. So intra-prediction is basically the encoder process frame video in a units of macro block 16x16 display pixels. It forms, so current block is 16x16 or 4x4. So it forms a prediction of the macro block based on the previously encoded data, either from the current frame, that is intra prediction, or from the other frame that have already been coded and transmitted. Interprediction, the encoder subtracts the prediction from the current macro block to from the form of a residual. The prediction methods supported by H.264 are more flexible than those in previous standard, enabling accurate predictions and hence efficient video compressing. Interprediction uses 16x16 and 4x4 block sizes to predict the macro block from surrounding previously coded pixel within the same frame. Interprediction uses a range of block sizes from 16x16 down to 14x4 to predict pixel in the current frame from similar region in previously coded frames. So the transform and quantization, the next one is a block of residuals. A block of residual sample is transmitted using a 4x4 and 8x8 integer transform, an approximate form of a discrete cosine transform that is also called as DCT. The transform outputs set of coefficients, each of which is a weighting value for a standard basis pattern. When combined, the weighted basis patterns recreate the block of residual samples. So in this figure, we will showing the coefficient weight, the weighting combination n to 4x4 image block. The output of the transform, a block of transform coefficient is quantized, that is each coefficient is divided by an integer value. Quantization reduces the precision of the transform coefficient according to a quantization parameter, that is QP. Typically this result is a block in which most or all of the coefficients are zero with a few non-zero coefficients. Setting QP to a high value means that more coefficients are set to 0, resulting in high compression at the expense of a poor decoded image quality. Setting QP to a low value means that more non-zero coefficient means after quantization, resulting in better decoded image quality but lower compression. Next one is bit stream encoding. The video coding process produces a number of values that must be encoded to form the compression bit stream. These values include quantized transform coefficient information to enable the decoder to recreate the prediction, information about the structure of the compressed data and the compression tool used during encoding, information about the complete video sequence as well. These values and parameters are converted into library binary codes using variable length coding or arithmetic coding. Each of these encoding methods produces an efficient compact binary representation of the information. The encoded bit stream can then be stored and transmitted. So decoding process of the bit stream decoding, a video decoder receives the compressed H.264 bit stream, decodes each of the syntax elements and extracts the information described above. Quantized transformation or coefficient prediction information, etc. These information is used to reverse the coding process and recreate a sequence of video images. Rescaling and inverse transformation. The quantized transformation coefficients are rescaled. Each coefficient is multiplied to be an integer value to restore the original scale to. An inverse transform combines the standard basis pattern weighted by the rescale coefficient to recreate each block of residual data. These blocks are combined together to form a residual macro block. Then the reconstruction. For each macro block, the decoder forms identical prediction to be an one created by the encoder. The decoder adds the prediction to the decoded residual to reconstruct a decoded macro block, which can then be displayed as a part of the video frame. So this is all about the bit stream decoding. In the previous slide, we have learned about the bit stream encoding. Now, where H.264 support and its adoption. H.264 is a video compression technology, or H.264 is one of the three codecs available for the encoding content for Blu-ray disc. Is prevalent in video conferencing products and is widely used in television broadcasting, including satellite and cable broadcasting. In the streaming market, H.264 was first adopted by Apple with the QuickTime 7 in 2005, and H.264 playback in an iPod also debuted that year in 2007. Adobe incorporated H.264 support into Flash, with Microsoft announcing support for H.264 support in Silverlight in 2008. Next one is H.264 is currently supported by all new Android devices in Windows Phone 7, in most new BlackBerry and smartphones, and the HP WebOS. In terms of browser support, H.264 playback is currently incorporated into Apple Safari browser and Microsoft Internet Explorer version 9, while the HTML5 video tag as well as the Google Chrome version through at least 11.0.696 16 beta. However, in January 11, 2011, Google announced that they will remove H.264 support from Google Chrome in the next couple months. Neither Mozilla or Opera have incorporated H.264 playback into their browser. Setting the cost and restriction of using a patent encumbered format. However, the Microsoft has released multiple plugins that enable H.264 playback within Firefox and Chrome using the HTML5 video tag through encoding to Microsoft. These H.264 plugins only runs on Windows 7. With version 10.1, the Flash Player enables GPU acceleration of H.264 playback within Flash on both the Windows and Macintosh platforms, and version 5 of their Safari browsers also accelerates H.264 playback on both platforms. With version 3, Silverlight also enables GPU acceleration of H.264 video on both platforms, and Internet Explorer 9 also includes GPU acceleration. Now, the H.264 compatible quality. So in previous slide, we have discussed about the where the H.264 technology is using in nowadays, and it's taking a lots of mark and capturing its lots of market value. In terms of video quality, H.264 is generally considered to produce higher quality than both on2's VPs and Microsoft VC1. Regarding WebM, there is some disagreement. For example, in their respected annual codec compression, Moscow State University found that when encoding movies VP8, the video codec in the WebM format showed 20-30% lower quality at an average. Another early evaluation of WebM by X264 developer Jason Garrett Glasser concluded that VP8 as a specification should be a bit better than H.264 baseline profile, and VC1, it's not even close to competitive with H.264 main or high profile. In contrast, streaming media concluded that the quality difference between VP8 and H.264 will be meaningless at most relevant data rates. In its application as well as its improved compression performance, H.264 offers greater flexibility in terms of compression option and transmission support. There are several other applications also available in a TV as well. Then a storage media integrated support for the transmission or storage. Then the 4AVC is being adopted for an increasing range of application, including high definition DVDs, high definition TV broadcasting in Europe, Apple products including iTunes video downloads, iPod videos and macOS, NATO and US DoD video applications. Mobile TV broadcasting, internet video and video conferencing is a better example of H.264. So this is all about the H.264. Hope you have understood it. If you have any queries or comment, please comment in the comment box so that I will check and revert with the resolution. Don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.